Everybody, it is crazy up here in Chicago. We had the most ridiculously intense windstorm yesterday. Last night. It was crazy. You're still seeing a little residue. Like, you can see that tree up ahead. Let me show you. That tree has no leaves. I'm sure yesterday had a thing full of leaves on there. What's up, Chantel? How are you doing? Hey guys, if you're on replay, you can fast forward. But if you're on live, you're with us, man. I'm just gonna let everybody come on in. Yeah, it's a wind advisory until 7 o'clock. It's crazy, y'all. It's crazy. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump into this one. I'm still driving a little bit. So good morning, everybody. Good to see you guys. Good morning. Hey, everybody. Good to see you. I'm just a few minutes away from my parking spot. But until then, I'm gonna go ahead and get this party started. I got a good one I wanna share this morning that I pray encourages you guys. But more than anything, I hope it gives you more insight into your life and into, you know what I'm saying? And it also, I think it's more about the future than it is about the past, what I wanna share today. So my topic today is the one word that Christians hate, but it is so important to God's strategy. And so I'm gonna give you my scripture. And the Bible says, well, whatever a man shall sow, a man shall reap. When you sow into the spirit, you shall reap the spirit. When you sow into the flesh, you shall reap the flesh, right? And so, this comes all the way back to God's strategy that we even see with Adam and Eve. The one thing that he implemented or he employed the moment that Eve ate the apple and that, you know, the fall of man, the one thing that came about that you saw God use for his strategy to how he dealt with Adam and Eve. And so, and then I see the thing going today that a lot of us Christians, we try to avoid this reality by patching it up with other terminology, patching it up with other concepts, and we try to escape out of it. But the reality is that it's so necessary. All right, I've kind of built it up. That one word, everybody, is consequences. Consequences. What is a consequence? A consequence is a result of an action that does not go. A consequence can be something that's a good consequence, or it can be a bad consequence. But the reality is, for us, for most of us, we look at consequences as punishment. We look at consequences as a failure. We look at consequences as a setback. We look at consequences as things that are here to hinder us or to hurt us. But I want to remind you to think about consequences as this, is that we make consequences about us instead of making it about God. Let me explain. And so you see with Adam and Eve, whenever Adam and Eve fell from the garden, when they ate that apple, their consequence was what? They were banished from the Garden of Eden. They had to go from the Garden of Eden. But God always has a way to turn things around and turn it for his good. And so even in our moments of our failure, because Paul talked about it in the book of Romans, how is it? So does that mean whenever we do a bad thing, for example, how God turned the good for the Israelites whenever they wandered in the wilderness for 40 years, how God turned that for his glory, right? And every single moment when someone does something bad or someone does something not up to par, or when one of us fails, God always has a way to turn it for his glory. Even whenever I've made some decisions in my life that I fully 100% believe was not 100% the Lord, but I've seen God literally turn it for his good. And then also, if it's for his good, he turns it for my good. But the reality is that a lot of us, we got to come away from this victim mentality. We got to come away from this. My life is over. My life is messed up. I made one bad decision. Now, you know what I'm saying? Whether it be you may have had a child or wedlock, you may have had a divorce, you may have dropped out of college, you may have gotten into a bad car accident because you were driving drunk, you may have got to a party, you may have got raped at a party, you may have all these things that can come about from a consequence of your action. I want to point the finger not back at you, but I want to point it back to God's ability to turn it for for your good, because that's how good God is, and that's how powerful and amazing his grace is. And that the thing is not about your situation, it's not about your action, but it's about God getting the glory no matter what. God is a God of restoration. You better believe that. And I want to tell you this morning, whether it may be that you didn't go to college, it may be that you didn't finish school, it may be that you had children too early, you may, whatever the thing is, you may feel like it's a setback, it's a setup from God. Listen to me this morning. Whatever you may feel is a setback is a setup, because God takes hard cases. God takes hard cases and he turns it for his good, and he uses it for his glory and as a demonstration of his power and how he can confound and profound and blow up and make those that may say, oh yeah, look at her, she had a child out of wedlock. Oh yeah, look at her, she got a divorce. Oh yeah, look at him, he over there, he's got 7 girls pregnant. Oh yeah, did you see about them? Because the thing is that your infidelity or your lack of wisdom for a situation may cause the haters, it may cause people to look at you and look down upon you, but the moment that begins to happen, it draws the hand of God to perform his power on your behalf. So consequences, look at me, or is an opportunity for you to be used by God in order to demonstrate his power in your life, to set you up for an opportunity for him to demonstrate how good he is. Because guess what? The more you've done bad, the more jacked up stuff you've done, the more stuff that may have come against you, the more stuff you may feel like there's no way my life is worth anything. I've done too many things, too many bad things. I've done too many bad deeds. I've done too many bad actions. But guess what? It is all of those things. When you build those things up, God looks at you and he says, you know what? I'm going to take your bad life. I'm going to take your drug addiction. I'm going to take your man womanizing. I'm going to take your hoish ways, your sluttish ways. I'm going to take all the things that everybody says about you, and I'm going to turn it for my good. I'm going to turn it for my power. I'm going to turn it for my glory. All you got to do is stop complaining, stop whining, and stop bickering, and stop sitting over there playing a pity party, and look at God and say, God, what can you do with me? What can you do with me? Consequences is a powerful thing. If you are living right now with any fear, not fear, but any stress of a consequence, or you are in the middle of a consequence, let me tell you right now, you better lift your hands up to Jesus and say, God, what can you do with this? Because God loves a challenge. God loves a challenge. What can you do with me, God? How can you turn this from your glory? Not about for me. I'm not trying to get a book deal for my story. I'm not trying to turn my story into a movie. God, I want to turn it into an opportunity for you to get glory. That's what it's all about. Now, you know, folks be over here, they be getting book deals and they getting movie deals. People use milking their issues, milking their problems, milking the bad things that happened to them. But guys, I want you to focus your attention on Jesus Christ, on God the Father. And because I'm telling you right now, listen to me, guys. This is my ending note. Yes, God is a judge. Yes, God is a very strong person, but at the root of who he is, listen to me, guys, and hear this. God is a father. God is a father, and God does not desire for you to fail. You hear me? It doesn't matter. You can go blow up the United States building, because the thing is that the reality, even those that were the terrorists for 9/11, God is still their father. And even though the world may hate them and thousands of people's lives are lost because of them, that's an opportunity for God to get a lot of glory. Just think about it. Think about it. If Saddam Hussein, before he got assassinated, think about if he would have gave his life to Jesus. Think about if he would have lifted his hands up to God and said, God, I've killed a lot of people's lives. I've done a lot of things that I'm not proud of. What can you do with my life? Think about the level of glory God could have received from his life. And God is a father. He's a father enough that he would have forgiven him, loved him, restored him, and put him back on the path towards righteousness and restoration. I want to encourage you, if they can get mercy, if they can get grace, I want to encourage you, how much more could you get it? Because I'm pretty sure we don't have any terrorists on this call right now. All right? I'm pretty sure we don't have anybody that's set up to murder thousands of people on this call right now. Whatever your situation is, whatever your consequence is, God is good enough, and he's a father to you, and he wants to forgive you, he wants to love you through it, but he needs you to stop playing a pity party and make something of your life, all right? I don't care what decisions you've made, what setbacks you've had, I'm telling you right now, God wants to use your life for His glory, every single part of it. All right. Now, does that mean we go around here and start sinning? We go around here and start using God's grace and start walking on and trampling upon it? Absolutely not. Paul talks about that. We never want to use God's grace as a toy. All right. God's grace is not a toy. It's not something to play with and trample with. It's a strategy. It's an instrument. It's a tool. You hear me? All right. So don't mess around with God. But I'm giving you this word today. No more pity party. All right. No more pity party. Your life means something. Everything you've done means something. God's going to use it, and He's going to set you up for glory demonstration in your life. Hey, guys, I love you. I'm praying for you. Bless each of you. I'm going to get in here. I'm so encouraged by your journeys, and I'm encouraged by every detail of your life, man. And so, hey, let's make something of it. Continue to rock and roll. Press through. Press on. Press harder. Become somebody. Be somebody. Don't let this thing stop you. You're greater than that. You're better than that. Guess what? Because you are a child of the living God. All right. I'm blessing each of you this morning with a word of encouragement. And let's make these consequences the things that Christians hate, but it's a part of God's strategy, is consequences, all right? I know you hate it. It ain't going to feel good. It ain't going to feel right. It ain't going to feel comfortable, because God is working it, all right? He's working and He's turning it. That's one thing I've learned, man. I'm looking at the consequences of my life and my decisions, the things that we've made some decisions with in the last year, and we are living in the best days ever, man. God is turning it for our good and turning it for our favor. All right, guys, I'm out of here. I'll see you guys later.